Well, in last video we have seen up to IU interfaces, and today we are going to see the second interface will be IUR interface. And this IUR interface, they will maintain a connection between SRNC and DRNC. SRNC stands for serving radio network core, and already we have know the meaning. So apart from this, the new meaning given for this SRNC, when the user equipment is connected to RNC, it became SRNC. And drift RNC, nothing but if you are adding the new radio links added to the user equipment, but this user equipment will be under the control of the different RNC. That means we are going to adding the new radio links with the user equipment, but this user equipment should be under the control of different RNC, and this DRNC will be applicable for soft handover. So what is the meaning of soft handover? Means when an user equipment is connected to two or more node B station simultaneously, that is the meaning of soft handoff mechanism. So this IUR interfaces, they will maintain a connection between one RNC and one node B station, but this one node B station will be belongs to two different RNC. That means we are going to using one RNC and one node B, and this one node B station having two different types of RNC. So next we are going to see the protocol structure of this IUR interface. So this IUR interface has three types of plane, like RNCP, TNCP and user plane. So this IUR interfaces, they are going to carry three informations, like radio control information, transport control information, packet and voice data information. So for this, we are using three types of plane, like RNCP, TNCP and UP. So this RNCP plane is used to carry the information of control radio resources along with to achieve the service request for the mobile phone. Similarly, and the IUR interfaces, they will carry the control information of transport network associated with the UTRAN on TNCP. And this IUR interfaces, they will carry the voice and data information along with UP. UP stands for user plane. Next, we are going to see the important protocols. So these are the different types of protocols. So there is no need to write the highlighted word. That's the meaning I given for this. So first will be RANAP, stands for Radio Access Network Application Port. And this protocol is mainly used for signaling process between the core network as well as the UTRAN. And second will be DCHFP. So this protocol will allocate a resource for the single user and not for the multiple user. And third will be RACH frame protocol. So this will be the uplink protocol. They will transport and carry the protocol information between the terminals along with the network. One more important point, this type of protocol is used to send a small packet, not the huge packet. And FACH frame protocol, they will downlink activity and they will carry the control information to the directly to the terminals located with the cells. And fifth one will be ALCAP, and already have studied ALCAP in the previous layers. That is, ALCAP stands for they mainly used to set up the transmit bearer, and this bearer will be used to carry the user and control plane information. So in this level, the 5th one, 6th one, 7th one and 8th one will be similar to the previous IU interfaces, and 6th one will be signaling connection control part. They'll providing extended routing, flow control, connection oriented services and segmentation, etc. I already explained in the previous topic itself. Similarly, 7th one, and this type of protocol is mainly used in public switch telephone network. And 8th one will be SAAL NNA, stands for signaling ATM adaptation layer for network to network interfaces. I once again show in the previous, so you can visualize the last video. Just a minute. So this is the three important level of SAAL NNI. So same protocol is also using in this corresponding IUR interfaces. That is, this SA SAALNNA, that is signaling ATM adaptation layer for network to network interface. They will further divide into SSCF, SSCOP and ATM adaptation layer 5. So you can visualize the previous video. And next we are going to see the important functions performing by the IUR interfaces. The first function will be basic inter RNC mobility support, that is they will supporting the relocation of SRNC, that is when one radio network component will be relocated or change over to another radio network component, that is nothing but SRNC. The second, we are going, this function will support the inter RNC cell and Utron registration area update. Inter RNC cell is nothing but making a intercommunication within the particular radio network component. And second will be Utron registration area updates, nothing but so first we know what is the meaning of registration area. Now it is a collection of cells that are used to for fast moving of user equipment, not for the slow process. This type of activity will be using for the fast moving level. And what when you are going to update in registration area, now there is no transferring activity or there is no transportation activity in the particular network. If the data will be transferred or transferring process will be going on, you cannot go for the updation. And third one will be support of inter RNC packet paging. Packet paging nothing but it is response which is sent by the mobile station and received by the network. And fourth one will be reporting of protocol error. Suppose any types of errors will be occurring on the mobile station or your user equipment or any types of base station, now we can use this function to report the protocol errors. And second will be dedicated channel traffic support. So we can establish or modify or release the dedicated channel in DRNC, because DRNC going to handling both handoff like hard as well as soft. So what is the main difference between dedicated and common channel? Nothing but dedicated channel is performing by limited amount of channels, as that is the functions will be performing based upon the their activity or configuration. Common channels will be applicable for all type of activities. And second one, they will set up and release the transport connections across the IUR interfaces. And third one, they will transfer the blocks between SRNC and DRNC. And fourth one, they're going to measure the report procedures as well as power setting procedures by using radio links of the DRNS. And this radio links of DRNS through dedicated channel, they will measure the report procedures as well as the power setting procedure. That is, power setting procedure is nothing but suppose we're going to increasing the power or decreasing the power. And the third important function will be common channel traffic support. That is, they will set up and release the transport connection across IUR for common channel. I'll explain the difference between dedicated and common. Common channel will be applicable for all the process. Dedicated channel will be applicable for limited number of process. And second important point, we are going to use split out the MAC layer between SRNC as well as the DRNC. So MAC layer using for SRNC will be MACD, and layer using for DRNC will be MACC and MACXH. This MACD is mainly used for data processing, and MACC and MACXH will be mainly used for multiplexing. So apart from this, this corresponding functions, in this function we can use a downlink data transmission which is performing on the DRNC and not in the SRNC. One more, they are supporting the flow control between the MAC layers like MACD as well as MACC and MACSH. MACD will belongs to SRNC and MACC and MACSH will belongs to DRNC. And fourth one will be global resource management support. We are going to transfer the cell measurements condition between two RNC, and they will transfer the node B timing activity between two RNC, because we are going to using one RNC, we are going to using one node B station, but this node B stations will belongs to two different RNC. So they are going to transfer the node B timing between two different RNCs. So up to this we finishing the IUR interfaces. Next we are going for IUB interfaces. So this IUB interfaces, they will maintain a connection between RNC and node B. That is only one IUB interfaces for each node B station. We cannot using multiple number of IUB interfaces. Each node B station having one IUB interfaces. This IUB interfaces is used for all the communications between RNC along with node B. But this RNC should belongs to same RNC. If RNC will not belongs to same RNC, now we cannot use this IUB interfaces. So similar to the previous interfaces like IUR interfaces, this IUB interfaces is also having three different plane like RNCP, TNCP along with user plane. So this is the protocol structure given for IUB interfaces. It also similar to the previous diagrams, but some types of protocols will be changed over. So what are the important functions performing by this IUB interfaces will be, so similar to the previous one, it also they also carry the general control informations of node B to operate operation on RNCP, nothing but radio network control plane. They will carry the control information of radio resources. They will carry the control information on transport network between Utron, which is performing on transport network control plane. And they will carry the voice and packet data information on UP stands for user plane. And apart from this, one more important function of this IUP interfaces of RNCP will be, they will carry CC. CC stands for call controlling messages and MM signaling messages. So this CC and MM signal messages are also similar to the first interface, nothing but IU interfaces I will show in the previous videos. Just a minute. So this is the CC, that is call control, and this is the MM, that is mobility management signaling messages. So call control is used to monitor and maintain the connection, and MM is nothing but they are going to track the subscriber who are all involved in the activity. And apart from this, next we are going to see the important protocols of the corresponding IUB interfaces. So the same protocol is also using in the IUB, like nothing but DCHFP, RACHFP, FACHFP, ALCAP, Q.AL2, MTP3, SSCP or TCP or IP. It will be similar to the previous one. The only one different protocols using in this IUB interface will be NBAP. NBAP stands for Node B Application Pod Protocol. And this protocol will maintain a signal. It's a signal protocol, and this protocol is used to control the node B by RNC. So similarly, the remaining all the one will be look after will mean the previous slide. So same definition, same meaning. So apart from this, suppose we are using the multiplex low speed link with the IUB interfaces, now node B will support inverse multiplexing for ATM, that is auto transmission mode layer, that is nothing but the IME. Suppose I am using high speed link, now there is no need for this activity. Suppose we are going into attaching the low speed link along with the IUB interfaces, now the node B will support inverse multiplexing activity. So apart from, we are finishing the third interfaces, and the fourth one will be UU interfaces. So the UU interfaces is a radio interface connected between the node B and any one of the user equipment. That means you can connecting one user equipment along with one node B station. So this UU interface, they will be interface through the UE. The UE can access the fixed part of the system. The best example of UE interfaces will be the router. So thus we are finishing the types of interfaces in the Utron. So this is a very important 13 mark question. They can also ask any two, or simply they can ask the full slide. So please mark in the note, that is it's an important 13 mark question. And second subdivision of this Utron will be the distribution of Utron functions. So in this case, we are going to see the two subdivision, nothing but location in the RNC function and location in the node B Utron function. So first will be located in RNC, that is same radio resource control, RNC radio link control, macro diversity combining. So this activity, cell modification, priority handling, multiplexing and demultiplexing of IL layer PDUs, selection of appropriate transport format for each transport channel depending upon the source state. Why are just I am reading the notes? Already we see this point in the first slide. It's sorry, in the second slide of the Utron. That is once again. So in the responsibilities of the RNCSL, we are seeing the macro diversity campaigning, and the second that is multiplexing and demultiplexing activity, along with this active cell modification, priority handling, etc., and radio resource control, etc. So thus we are seeing the same point in the last slide, nothing but the location in the RNC. Similarly, located in the node B, they are mainly used for scheduling of broadcast paging along with the notification messages. And the main important function in the node B by Utron, they will reduce the non-constructive data traffic over IUB interfaces, and they will reduce the round trip. So what is the meaning of round trip? Nothing but they will round trip delay, nothing but they will calculate the length of sending time, and they will calculate length of acknowledgement time, and they will add both sending time along with the acknowledgement time. That is the thing but the round trip time. If this time will be very very slow based upon the original value, now this is nothing but the round trip delay. So up to this we finishing the important 13 mark of unit number 3. Thank you.